giving up and living here. The idea of just, you know, maybe I want to get it, a workout in and and, you know, keep my body in shape. But of course, you know, this would be fine if like my gym up the street would just open or allow me to go in at 8 when nobody's there, instead of me driving an hour one way and driving an hour back the other way.
Yeah.
And actually I want to like get a good one in and spend an hour and a half and, like getting my mind ready so I can work and be more productive. No, I just know what I need to do. I just need to get 6 hours of sleep and come straight in here.
Oh boy. Oh, listen, that's why. Let me see.
That's okay. People can just take doctor's appointments at 1 o'clock and not come back at all. Why would you do that? Even though you're the only person in the office that doesn't know how to ship. Just clog up everything. Let's get a day behind. Behind because the shipping guy just leaves in the middle of the day.
Instead of
when he shows up at 11. Why should I worry? He shows up at 11. He's leaving at 1. It's not like he's like, I'm leaving at 1, but I'm going to show up at 8.
The Buddy and Bill show, this is the George and the Scott.
I'm about to slap Lance Russell for no reason whatsoever. This may be the day I
just
curse.
To do it.
This may be the day. I would say the, but I've cursed on here before. This would be one of the three episodes where I've cursed.
We got to get on the air first. Then we'll knock this out. I'm sorry.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the edition of Daddy to Work You Wrestle. You're the clap, you know time. It is George Howard's weekend.
I'm afraid to clap my hand. Folks, if you realize at home watching what has transpired just to make this
I've
special
said the F
moment
at least three times in front of George. At least three.
It's like you...
I screamed it down the hall, but I don't know. It would be four, but I screamed down the hall. I wasn't for sure if you were there.
I didn't hear that.
Okay, I screamed it down
like,
the hall.
It's like... You know, I'm dad. It's like I'm cleaning your room while you're outside, while you're going to school, and I found Playboy books. Okay, that's all I'm saying.
I wish it was as small as that.
And I don't know whether that's what. Yeah, when I heard you, because I slid it, but it's not too wild yet, is it? So I just slid the Playboy books back under the mattress. Is that okay?
Well, you prefer that as opposed to me going online. Like, if that's what you're finding in those books, if you're looking at my search history, especially now, if you're looking at my search history right now, George, you would look at me as a different human being.
Well, I'm into
some weird stuff, and most people know that from after the virtual gimmick table with Scott Steiner. And the thing is, too, like, everyone's like, oh, I've known a lot about your sex life now. Like, really?
Yeah.
There's a lot more to it than just that. All I made it clear is like I've done it before, like that, and everyone's like, I know so much about.
What's funny is like, you've done 400 programs, auctions, and selling all this memory business stuff like that, and they don't even pay attention. But you mentioned that.
Sexual being, and all of a sudden like, I knew so much about you. All it said is like, have you had it before? And I just went yes.
And you're like,
that's way too much information. Whoa.
And you got like 400 new friend requests like the next day.
I haven't had a match in about 3 weeks now, which is surprising. Because I'm a one-of. Nobody's compatible with me because I'm a one-of.
But after you made that comment, you even got MySpace.
That's the problem. I need to go to MySpace.
You see what I'm saying?
Also, too, like, you know, I'm not on Instagram. I guess that's where all the action is.
Yeah, exactly. And the new, Lord, thank the Lord for my
Snapchat?
Flip phone.
Yeah. Never get on Snapchat, George. The world's coming down.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Oh, no, I couldn't. And even the, what's the new one that somebody was saying?
TikTok.
What the heck's that?
The fact that you know TikTok disturbs me.
No, I think
if you're doing TikTok videos with your cat, which by the way, it still blows my mind that you have a cat and you didn't tell anybody.
I'm sorry.
Hey, by the way, George, let you know, I have a brother. I have a brother.
Well, listen, I'm going.
I just thought I'd share that with you because we've been together for like 15 years.
Yes, we have.
By the way, I've never mentioned that I had a brother, but guess what? I have a brother. How about that? Now you know how it feels like.
No, I apologize. Man, but see, I don't want you to get to that point in your life like my grandbabies
I'm at that point right
now. See, my grandbabies felt like I was alone. Which I am, and they felt sorry for me, so they find me this like mountain goat. Okay, they found and which I thought my plan was first few days just leave the door open when I leave. Okay, but I didn't know that the grandbabies who are on Snapchat and TikTok and all that kind of stuff would be asking me how Gimmick's doing like every day. So it ain't like I can just put a stuffed cat over there and say Gimmick's fine. Look, you see what I'm saying? So anyway. It lives in the back of the house. I live in the front.
I saw that picture and how lovingly you were holding it. And then I had an image in my head of you lovingly petting an animal. And I'm like, I don't want to think about this anymore. the idea of you going, oh, like, no, like no. Good cat or whatever, or
well, showing, see, that's what all
showing
these
animal affection.
Are.
I don't want to.
But listen,
you're much like when they said about Michael Jordan, the only emotion you ever showed was anger and frustration. That's the only thing I want to see from you.
Yeah, just wait till we go through the airport and somebody asks me, hey, George, Bullet, hey, George.
You petting a cat is about as disturbing as me making out with a woman. Like, what? How is that happening? There's love there.
And they say, George, what is, who's going to take the last shot? Yeah. Okay, ask me that in the airport. You see what I'm saying? Like, it did Michael Jordan.
I've been rewatching that, actually. I love that. I had to stop again when that part came up. I'm like, I love it.
That's my favorite part.
Shot Ahmad Rashad.
Yeah, exactly. Like, what are you going to do? They going to sit down and have a glass of tea and discuss it? No, Michael Jordan. Anyway, welcome, folks. We just talked for 10 minutes. I'm so glad to see that you did survive the Steiner line virtue.
I did. I had to pop my neck. I was like, it's together.
See, so, you mentioned her name, and but I was just sharing here with.
I was on camera with Scott Steiner for 90 minutes.
Bullet, and you.
You find me one person on the planet.
Amen. They don't exist. I'm gonna tell you.
And made it as entertaining as we did. But, now, granted, it's easy with Scott.
I'm telling you right now. I just explained to Dr. Journey how when Scott first came to WCW, everybody knows that. Man, he was jacked and he was still learning and I remember he broke Tommy Angel's nose and then of course they said you're not ready yet, so they sent him to Memphis, remember, and he went up there for a while and then came back. And but I was just telling Dark Journey what was funny is me and Ricky Nelson wrestled then when they left here and went to WWF. I never forget, my body had not healed yet from WCW matches. So we go up there, me and Ricky Nelson had them one of their first WWF matches. So I'm scared to death. I can't get away from them, okay? But I go up there, that match was unbelievable. Bullet, they touched me like Bullet Bob Armstrong. I'm like, Bullet, they were so easy. And then I was more confused. So I remember we come back to the dressing room. I said, y'all can work when you want to. So they could work when they wanted to.
It's funny. I was on talking to Scott Steiner for 90 minutes. And we had a discussion of the Incredible Hulk. Because we were talking about bodybuilders and talking about Lou Ferrigno. And he goes, I love Lou Ferrigno and the Hulk. He goes, the only problem is the Hulk didn't show up until like the last 5 minutes. And I was trying to explain to him, but I felt like you talking to Ron Simmons. I was like, well, you know, Scott, the reason why they didn't put the Hulk until like the end is so you could sit around and watch a television program. And like then the Hulk at the end and you can go send him home happy. And like you got to get a little heat on Bill Bixby. And then he turns into the Hulk. That's how the episodes go. It's like, I just wanted a whole hour of the Hulk beating the crap out of people. It's like, I was trying to teach them how to work. And I don't care about that. Yeah. They don't want to see that. I just want to see the Hulk beat the crap out of somebody for an hour.
No, that's very Ron Simmons. So much going on, Bullet. Tell me your opinion real quick on this. I know we got to do it quick.
Against. That's my opinion.
Bullet, and I've actually, we're still in this discussion. Bojangles, one of my favorite places. They're not going to Idiot a Week this week, but, you know, they're running a special, Bullet. Any size tee for $1, okay? Now, I love their tee. That's why I'm bringing this up, okay? Any size tee for $1, okay? So I pull around, Bullet. I'm going to grab my, on the way, I was going to grab my tee only for $1, Bullet, okay? I had $1. I even had the pennies for the change. So the lady asked me with the intercom, she says, well, what size? Okay, that may be a fairly question, but Bullet, let me tell you something. I do not know one human being in the world, okay, that would have got anything if you can get the small for $1 or the big gulp for $1. Mm-hmm. I do not know one person in this world. I really don't, Bullet, that would have said, could I have the small? Okay? So as I'm waiting, stupid me brought this discussion up to this lady at Bojangles. And she said, oh, no. And she starts for 20 minutes that I can't get back. She was very smart, too, because she didn't hand me the tea first because I'd have been gone. But she's explaining to me the whole concept of any size drink, any size tea or any size for $1, okay? I did not want to hear it, but I didn't have my drink yet. So what I'm saying here, Bullet, is there can't be one person, I'm sure maybe a fan of this show, I can't believe there's one person that would actually pick the small. Could you? I don't know. Everybody's wanting to get your money's worth.
If you get small, you at least get a regular.
I said, lady, just give me the big gulp. She said, well, a lot of people choose this. So I said, oh, my God. I don't know anybody. I don't want to even admit that anybody would choose the small T on that when you can get any size for a dollar. Anyway, has nothing to do with wrestling. There ain't no wrestling going on. Boy, I did see this. Did you see Dak Prescott? He has just built, listen to this, boy. I think it was kind of kayfabe when it got out. He, in his backyard, he just built a plague virus friendly football field. Okay? So him and all the wide receivers are working out. Getting
he's got
ready.
Some great wide receivers. I mean, it ain't gonna be hard. So, boy, I mean, you can like you just throw it around in a sandlot; they're gonna be good.
Oh,
like,
boy! So this is a. But
those passes aren't gonna come very easily unless you're gonna hand that ball off.
Oh, and bullet Zeke. But listen, it's a family friendly dome, a mini dome, his own in his backyard. And so if that's family friendly, bullet, why don't society learn something from that? If that's family friendly, they're out there in sweats, tank tops. They're not worried about no mask. They're not worried about the plague at all. Bullet.
And Jerry Jones is still scratching his head like, hey, I don't know if you're a franchise quarterback. We're not sure. We're not really for
what's
sure.
What's brother got to do? That's all I'm saying. But anyway, so much, Bullet. Ain't really nothing. I was so happy to see our friends Rick and Robert. They was on. You explained to me that it wasn't A&E, that there is another program.
Yeah.
There is another company, AEW.
AEW.
Yeah. See, I didn't know that. See, I was thinking
we're
it was
get
all.
We're gonna get closer every week.
I can't keep up. I can't keep up
elite,
with them all.
Only wrestling.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true. And I found out something new today that their action figures are out. Holy cow!
Yeah,
So
I'm required to go into a Walmart in the middle of the pandemic. That's one thing I'm supposed to be doing right now. I'm supposed to put my health at risk to go buy plastic action figures.
I love that, Bullet.
And random ones. Like, please venture out into as many Walmarts as possible. when if I get sick, the whole system goes down. I wasn't here for the first 3 hours of today. We've already seen how that's going.
Oh, gosh, yeah, we did.
Let's go pull Jake Manning into a Walmart. I didn't go to a Walmart before the pandemic because there were so many people there. Think I'm gonna go in now?
And Bullet, I mean, I was here to help you take $300,000 cameras
sorry. I was so persnickety.
That's okay. I love that, Bullet. No, I love that. Listen, you know what it reminded me of? It reminded me of in WCW when someone got fired from WWF, Bullet, and came down to try to get a job. They got a dark match in between the tapings at center stage. So guess whose number was called? I cannot tell you the guys that didn't even get a job. That's what I'm hinting at. And I'll never forget.
Why is Max Moon beating the crap out of me?
Yes! And boy, guess what? They brought nails straight out of it. He had just worked a big angle and fired. And next day, I think he's...
Oh, yeah, the guy that choked Vince McMahon. Yes. With George.
Boy, I'll never forget. We're talking about TV cameras and expensive cameras. In our match... Bull, after he had done beat the crap out of me, he reached over and tried to grab Jackie Crockett's camera, who was the cameraman. He was going to hit me with it. But Jackie, you know, is that's my lifeblood. And they're sitting there struggling. The camera's doing this way, Bullet. And luckily, he never got it to hit me with it, Bullet. So
that whiskey strength that Jackie kicked in.
So thank the Lord. But that made me think about Grandpa the cameras. Strength. That's how I felt with you out there. At the car when I tried to grab a...
Fighting with it. So I was nails.
Yeah.
That's about right.
No, I just fought with nails for a camera so you people could watch this show. So anyway, and then, that reminded me of one of those matches. Of course, it was one thing to get beat up, but the guys never got hired from it. And you know, that was the famous story I told you that when, and he did it, when me and Stallion was going to wrestle Jack Victory and Rip Morgan, who was the New Zealand militia, okay? Their first match in WCW came in, and Stallion, for some reason, he told Jody Hampton, he said, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going out there. And I remember even Rip Rogers said, Stallion, you know what they're paying you for? And Stallion says, I don't care. I'm not going out there.
I'm pretty sure that Rip got at least five curse words in there.
Oh, yes.
He sounded like I did earlier.
But listen. Stallion did not. You know what? Stallion told Jody. He said, "These guys are just going to be gone next week. Why are we got to?" And I'm thinking, Stallion, now you got a conscience after all these years, and I just want in there to beat me. I'm saying, Stallion, what you mad at? I'm taking the finish from them anyway. So, but Stallion didn't go out there and do that match. Well, they stuck someone else in there, and of course we went out there and Stan didn't even work that TV. And so he said, I'm not going to do it.
Oh. But now, Bobby Eaton job to Ultimo Dragon. I was searching through on Bobby's birthday on the WWE Network, and I saw Bobby Eaton versus Ultimo Dragon. I go, how did this turn out? Wow. And know how it turned out? Yeah. Bobby punched Ultimo Dragon, and then basically he sat up on the second rope and Ultimo gave a hurricanrana, 1, 2, 3.
Yep,
That's how that went down.
Yeah, I've seen that towards the end many times with poor Bobby, but he just went out there and done it. But it was just so weird that one time, for some reason. Now, the following week, Stan went back to tagging with me, and we were beat by Van Hammer and you know, the Renegade and all them. But for that one moment, for some reason, I remember when it was all over, Stan went up to Jack Victor and says, you know, it ain't personal.
Ain't personal, but I'm going to job next week.
Yeah, but I ain't losing to y'all, okay? Yeah. But anyway, so much that really ain't going on, Bullet, but idiot of the week, if you don't mind. Mm-hmm. Bullet, listen, you know, we're living in the worst times in the history of worst times. just to get everybody excited, okay? Mm-hmm. Bullet, this week they made an announcement. I don't care about the NFL. I don't care about nothing else that's been canceled. Even wrestling shows that took food out of my families. But Bullet.
Out of your families.
Bullet, listen. They announced this week a cancellation that broke my heart. The Southern Christmas Show in Charlotte that I have loved since I used to have to go there with Klondike Bill and help set up Christmas trees. They canceled it. It was supposed to be in at the end of November. Mm-hmm. They have canceled it. Okay, Bullet? Now, before I throw that whole situation in the idiot bag, my question to the society is, this is supposed to be the end of November. How do they know? So they just exposed the business of viruses because they just, so you're telling me
we ain't winning the belt in November.
Yeah, you can't let that out to the Rizzats that quick. You see what I'm saying? Bullet, so...
Or Mizarks.
Yeah, Mizarks.
You can't let that be Mizarks. That's right.
But Bullet, how... So I'm mad, okay? First of all, that it's canceled, okay? But Bullet, how do they know in the end of November? So you're telling me, well, I don't have Mama Bullet's mask on.
Because we book in to win the belt in January, that's why.
Yeah, Bullet.
We're going to win in Survivor Series.
No.
So Survivor Series when the screw job happens. You know, and you're going to win the belt at the Royal Rumble, and the winner of the Royal Rumble, there's going to be a face-off at the end, and we're supposed to be excited about this, but it's got Roman Reigns in it. Like, nah, I'll pass.
So I'm going to throw the whole, but I just don't understand. So give us a chance. So I can wear my mask and wash my hands up till November, but they've already exposed
the
title change.
We're not winning the belt.
No matter what we do.
No, we ain't winning.
To work the system, I mean, to do what we're told, we know, Bullet, by November, we ain't getting a belt.
Well, here's the thing, too, you got to keep in mind is, you know, most common people are going to go to that. Let's say they get a vaccine in October. Only the rich people are getting that vaccine by November. The rich people will have a Southern Christmas show. Show would be fantastic. By the time they allow poor people to get that vaccine, it's going to be March of next year.
It's going to be like the Grinch's tree.
Yeah.
You know, there'll be no bulbs on it.
Like, India's going to come over with a vaccine in about 2 weeks, and all the rich people are going to have it. It ain't going to be till like March or like sometime next spring before we're allowed to have it.
But listen to me. The virus, and I'm going to throw them in the bag, then I'm going to shut up. The virus will not win with me because, listen to this, but I've outsmarted them. I've outsmarted Paul Bosch's title change, okay? Mm-hmm. What I'm going to do, because my grandbabies was excited about going to Southern Christmas Show. But listen to this. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put all my grandbabies in a buggy, and I'm going to take them to either Lowe's or Walmart when they start. Well, Walmart's already starting putting up some Christmas stuff, okay? So, Bullet, my grandbabies won't know the difference. See what I'm saying? So I'm going to put them all in a buggy. We'll have a mask on, but we're going to go in either Walmart or Lowe's. I got a choice.
Go to Walmart, pick up some AEW figures. That's do that for me.
And so we're still going to the Southern Christmas Show. You see what I'm saying? It's just going to say...
Far more Southern Christmas shows here.
Little Dallas is going to look up and say, Papa, why does it say Walmart up here at the front of the convention center downtown? I'm just going to say they sponsor it. I got to think all this out. So, anyway, the whole Southern Christmas Show society will be put in there because they just canceled it. Well, they just canceled Christmas.
They talked to Dave Meltzer.
Yeah. They're going to have Harley Race with a light shining on him, Bullet. Mm-hmm. Saying,
we have stunt grannies.
What the heck, boy? Let me tell you something. See, that's why I'm not waiting to the end. That's why I'm dogging everything now. That's why I'm telling everybody. Well, ain't nothing left to expose. They don't beat us to it. But anyway, so I will throw. I already did. I'm sorry. We throw the whole. There's going to be no Southern Christmas show.
Yeah, but, give me a more Southern Christmas show.
way down Southern Christmas shows where me and the grandbabies are going through. Anything, Bullet? Any comedy? Anything besides the great comedy?
I have a wrestling show this Saturday, Black Label Pro. This will be interesting. I'm going to have a gimmick table, but I'm going to have gloves. I'm going to have hand sanitizer. I'm going to have a mask on. I will be selling merch, but I will be taking all the precautions in the world. So we'll see how this goes.
Let me ask you one question before we go. I got to know before I leave. Did Steiners acknowledge your opposition T-shirt that you had on at the
first 30 seconds, the first three minutes?
Oh, folks, just to update
he had a Michigan hat on. He goes, "I don't like that shirt."
Did he?
And it wasn't a Hawkeye one. It had Hayden Fry on it. But he knew. But Scott knew it was Hayden Fry because he knew Bo Schembechler or whatever his name was. Bo Schembechler, whatever. I said it perfectly on camera, but now I can't say it now. But the Michigan football coach, he's like, "I know Hayden Fry," and he saw it right on my shirt, and he Scott right away.
I love that.
He zeroed in.
Oh, I love
immediately.
That. Oh, Bullet. So that made my day. If you'd have said, "Well, he didn't really acknowledge it," no. I kind of had to keep showing it to him. But I love that.
We didn't go 2 minutes.
I love that.
Saying something to me about it, and then also too, when we got it on camera later, we came up with a new catchphrase for him. Because he was saying F Triple H, well, you know, Scott, really kind of in this new climate, the appropriate thing to do is, with all due respect, F him. And so then he caught on to that. So the whole rest of the show, he goes, "With all due respect, you know, F him." You know, or screw this guy, and this guy's awful, with all due respect.
Bullet, for you to survive and to make it entertaining. Was just another.
We could have done 3 hours. Yeah. We almost did.
Yeah.
Facebook wouldn't allow us to.
Just with another resume. What a resume you're going to have when you finally.
That's why I can't get a match. Nobody matches with me because I'm a one of.
All right, folks, listen to me. We promise this week. We will not cancel the shipments of
the second greatest book of all time, which is available at highspots.com. Make sure you go to highspotsauctions.com to get your pre-orders for this week's virtual gaming table and all the other wonderful things that are available on that website as well. So make sure you tune in this Thursday with Brian Cage and Ricky Starks, as well as all the other shows and all the other live auctions on the High Spots Superstore Facebook page and YouTube page. Of course, check me out at Manscout Manning on Instagram and at Manscout Manning on Twitter. This has been another edition of Dad, You Don't Work, You Wrestle.
I was going to say the Southern version of
that
didn't work.
It's kind of a give the information and get out.
Yeah.
It was very much the opposite of what I do in the virtual gaming table. I have to give all the information and then be entertaining.
Yeah, exactly.
So I just wanted to say all the information.
And we've never been entertaining here, so
no,
why should we start?
We stacked it all at the beginning. Yeah. There's no reason to do that. We stacked it all at the beginning.
Good. Well, thank you, buddy.
Thank you.